Okay, I think we got everything, so I'll control this. Okay. If late people come in, you can give them this. And okay, ready to get started? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I think we'll get started. Welcome to the flipped classroom experience. Of course, you know, my name is Evelyn. I'm the director of the ELC. And today, I'm delighted to be here with four of my current students who are freshmen in an EAP general education course here at the University of Macau. So they're first year students. They're all 18 to 19 years old. And I'm just delighted that they have built up enough confidence in the flipped classroom that now they can present at an international conference like this. So you've got to definitely join me to give them a round of applause, because that's a big achievement. So maybe they can quickly just introduce their names before we get started.
Good afternoon. I'm Erica, and I'm a year-one student.
Hello, my name is Marina.
I'm Susan.
I'm Vivian.
Okay, great. So these are some of the things we're going to do in the next 25 minutes. And we're going to begin by talking about what a traditional classroom is first, so that we can define what the flipped classroom is in comparison. So tell me about a traditional classroom. What usually happens?
Teacher-centered,
good. What else?
You don't ask us questions.
I don't ask you questions, that's right, good. What else?
Sit down, shut up, and listen.
Sit down, shut up, and listen. Very good, you guys have some great answers. Anything else? That's it, right? The sage on the stage, right? So the teacher does all the talking, does the lecturing, and the students passively engage with the material just by listening, right? Maybe that had a time and a purpose in the 80s and the 90s, but obviously, as Dr. Soon was talking about, things are very different now, and the way that we approach teaching and learning also has to be very different. So what I have come to do the last couple of years here at the ELC has been a flipped classroom. Who has not heard of this term before? Raise your hand if you're totally unfamiliar. Okay, so there are a few people. Good, good. So I'll spend some time talking about the history and what it is, and then we'll hear a little bit more from the students and what their perspective on the flipped classroom is. So the flipped classroom is just like the word says. It's flipped. It's upside down. It's an inverse classroom. So normally, like you said, the teacher lectures in class. But in the flipped classroom, there's no lectures in class. If there's any lecture or any instruction that the teacher must give, it's through videos or screencasts or podcasts that the students can watch at home. So that's where I say all classwork is done at home. So all lectures, all instruction, all assignment details, all rubrics are done at home, where the students can watch anytime, 24/7, via online videos or podcast. And then normally, students in the traditional classroom have homework. They write essays. They do problem solving. They answer questions at home in the traditional classroom. But in the flipped classroom, we do this in class. Why? Why do you think we would want to watch students solve problems in class? Why would we want them to write essays in class? What do you think would be the rationale behind that? So anyone want to volunteer?
Feedback,
good. Feedback from the teacher, feedback from each other, right? More peer review so that they can teach each other. So before, students are writing at home, we don't know what kind of problems they have. But if they're writing in class, and often writing with a partner or with a group, then we see their struggles and we can help them immediately solve those problems. So the flipped classroom allows for more individualized instruction and allows the teacher to really allow students to engage with the materials. But obviously technology, because I said screencast, videos, podcast, Those are all technology. So in the flipped classroom, technology definitely plays a key role. So the reason why that I took up this study 3 years ago when I first came to Macau was because I thought this was a great way, like Dr. Soon said, to address the seven C's, the 21st century skills, especially creative thinking, communication, the use of computers. Those are all important skills. I thought this would help to increase student learning outcomes. And here is really one of my big motivations. I had heard a lot about the flip in the K through 12 system in the United States, so secondary, middle school, primary school, but there was little flipping in the university, especially in a university where EFL, English as a foreign language, dominates. So I thought that I could gather some data that would really contribute to this field because there was so little data in this area. So as I said, the data is now in its third year. So here are just some brief benefits of flipping. Like I said, more time for student engagement, more individualized instruction, and this is really important, online materials and videos that students can access anytime, anywhere. So they don't necessarily have to be in the classroom, although the classroom is a key component to the flip. They can access the materials anywhere. So in the first year, I looked at some satisfaction surveys that I gave to the students, my own observations. Year two, they were in my year two data group. They took a technology survey at the beginning of class and then again at the end of the semester in 14 weeks. My own reflections, they wrote massive reflective essays at the end of the semester. They kept daily action logs where they recorded their reflections. They were part of a focus group session, and then of course my own observations. And then in year three, they re-registered for my course, so they are actually part of the year three data as well too. I've integrated some grammar instruction. So I will have the results of the grammar survey and the 10 weeks of instruction and the 10 quizzes, as well as reflections. And I've also added, there is an ETS writing program called Criterion. So I've added Criterion into the data this year, and they are working on their writing with Criterion. So you can see that I've accumulated a massive amount of data. Now it's just a matter of analyzing it and finding the time to analyze it. Okay, so we have a video that I think we would like to show you about what our flipped classroom looks like. It's only about 2 minutes long. Oh, wait, we didn't put in the thing. Hold on. You always have to be prepared in the flipped classroom too. Okay, let's see if it works. No, too low. Where's the teacher? Okay, that should be it. Okay, let's go. Thank you. So that was just a look about our flipped classroom, and now suddenly the PowerPoint is going a little crazy. What kind of things did you see from the video? Can people shout out a couple of things that you saw?
Lots of group work.
Lots of group work. Very good. Awesome. What else?
People standing
up, right, using their body and communicating. Good. What else? They were on task. Good. Excellent.
Peer review, it might be a topic you need to train them.
Very good. That's right. Yeah, and I do an extensive program with peer review. That's a great point. Good. Anything else?
No teacher.
No teacher. That's right. There was not one photo of me. That they're the center of the classroom. I'm just on the side as a facilitator and a guide. What did you see with the phones? Did you see a lot of phones? That's right. So other teachers like to say, put your phones away, or I'll collect your phones at the beginning of the lecture. But I don't. I tell them, keep your phones there. And you can tell when a student's messing around and when they're really using their phone for work. So I tell them, if you need to find a vocabulary word, check the dictionary. I want you to, yesterday, we searched our phones for information about Los Angeles because we were doing a TED talk on Los Angeles. So find some information on your phone. So it's good to include it in the classroom. So again, you're meeting those seven C's. And students come to see the phone, not as social media, but as an educational tool as well. So we also use computers. You saw us in the computer lab many times. And iPads. Those are some of the key technologies in our classroom. So I think you've heard enough from me. Now I would like you to hear from the students. So they prepared a few questions, but I think they can also impromptu take questions at the end of the workshop. So let's see. Question number one. Okay, who can tell me how is the flipped classroom different from other classes you've taken? And you might want to come forward because you guys are very quiet.
Okay. Hi everyone, my name is Marina. I experienced the flipped class approach last semester, and now I'm going to talk about the specialty of this flipped class approach to all of you. For the flipped class approach, we will have many group discussion and group activities like peer reviews. That is, we learn at home through the video lectures and reviewing some chapters of the book so that we can be well prepared before having lesson. We do the learning at home and the direct in-meeting discussion during class. Our teachers give us guidance on solving students' problems so that we can know our questions. This is very different from other traditional GE courses that I've taken, like Buddhist and psychology class. For instance, in the psychology class, we listen to the lecture of the teacher for most of the class. We do not have much interactivities within each other, so that it's hard for us to know each other. As what you can expect, the atmosphere is very serious and formal during the class. It is very lecture-based and teacher-centered. In contrast, for the flipped class approach, we have many group discussions and group activities. As I am a UN student, it is really the first class that I can know all of the students in my class. You know, it's usually very hard for us to know all of the students in a class during the university life. Moreover, the lecture is more interesting and interactive. Although I have more assignments to do than other traditional PE courses, like writing essays and do independent learning, I really improve a lot either in my oral or writing skills. And as I become more confident before having lesson, I can do preparation at home. Therefore, we just got two absences from last whole semester. That's why I really love this flipped class approach and this embrace active learning and it's very student centered. Thank you.
Wow. So Marina said something I want to draw your attention to. In 14 weeks, 42 hours of class, 24 students. I had two absences last semester. That's very impressive, right? So the flip, because they're doing the preparation at home, they feel like, well, I did all that work, so I gotta go to class now. So they're not looking for excuses to miss class. They want to come to class, which I think is very important. So my next question are about the benefits. So are there any benefits to this type of learning?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, come on.
So good afternoon. I'm Erica, and I'm a local student. From my experience, I know that the flip class is not very common in Macau. The English class was the first time that I came across with the flip class, and I think it's really amazing. This benefited me not only learning English, but also my future studies. There are several technologies used in the flipped class, which I think is very useful, just like the Word-Thread. The Word-Thread is an online media in which we submit our oral assignment. Speaking is an important part in learning languages, but then I think it's quite impossible for all the students to talk individually during class as time is limited. With this, the Word-Thread can help. Usually, we'll follow the guidelines recorded in a short video by our instructor, and then we record down our answers and upload it to the Word-Thread. This provides me a chance to improve my speaking. Moreover, I may also listen to my classmates' answers so that I can learn more from them. Criterion is another useful website which helped me to improve my writing. This will provide detailed grading automatically only by uploading my essay onto it. This also provides me some feedbacks and corrections so that I know what kind of mistake I've made and avoid to make the same mistake again. I think this can help me to improve my writing skill at home. Whenever I'm free, I can do some practices so that I don't have to submit my paper to my teachers and wait for grading. Aside from this, the in-class time is also very interesting and enjoyable. We usually have discussions, peer reviews, and activities during class. The teachers are no more standing in front of the classroom as talking at the student. Instead, they are coming to us and talking with the students. Usually, they will join our discussion and giving me immediate response. The atmosphere of learning is relaxed and interesting. And this is the main reason that makes me don't want to absent from classes. Being as a student who benefits so much from the flipped class, I highly recommend it to all of you, as it can really help to improve the student's learning. Thank you.
Good job. And if you want to learn more about VoiceThread, I'm going to be setting up my account for everyone in my 3 o'clock session tomorrow. And you can experience VoiceThread yourself as a student and as a teacher if you come to my session tomorrow. Okay, so there must be some difficulties though. It can't all be good. So who can tell me some of the problems with the flipped classroom?
I will do it.
Okay, come on up.
Actually, I encountered many difficulties in flipped classroom. The first one I want to share with you about communication. The flipped class requires us to do many communication with our classmates, and firstly, communicating with some of our classmates can be difficult. Because for most of the class activities, we are randomly grouped together, and so it's totally possible that your partner is a very quiet person. And if you have to work with such a person, you should try very hard to encourage him or her to express your feelings and thoughts. And I remember that last semester when we were having a mini debate, the opposite debaters were relatively quiet. They didn't refute our arguments much, so we didn't know what to do as well. So although we tried very hard to break the silence, our debate still cannot progress very smoothly. And moreover, as our class is very student-centered, we have many chances to either express ourselves in groups or in front of the whole class. Sometimes we even have the chance to be as a teacher to teach a small part of the lesson. And I remember, I remember that last semester we have some impromptu presentations and dramas, also role plays. It's really challenging for us to continue to use English, especially when you're standing in front of the whole classroom and presenting and acting, but you can't find the correct words to make your expressions complete. And the second one is about preparation. The flipped class requires us to prepare in advance, and otherwise you will be left behind. I remember when I last semester when we were studying rhetorical appeals, we were supposed to preview the chapter before the class. So in the class, Evelyn just reaffirmed the definitions, and right away she showed us many posters and asked us to figure out which rhetorical appeals was being used. But unfortunately, I forgot to preview the chapter. So I was totally confused by the three definitions, and I just couldn't follow my classmates' pace. And it took me a long time to read the chapter after class and go through all the posters again to confirm my understanding. So you see, the preparation is really important, and it can be challenging due to the large amount of tasks, and especially when other courses also have many requirements for us to complete. And the last one I want to share with you is about using technology to make our class activities more diversified. We use many technologies, but it sometimes can be troublesome. I remember the first time I used VoiceThread, it almost drove me crazy because I can't find it. I was asked to leave a verbal comment on the video, but I can't find the button that enabled me to do that. And after I finally found the button with the Mac shape, I clicked on it, but it's still not working. And I finally found that only if I start speaking, it will enable me to click at the button to start to end recording. And it almost took me 1 hour to finish this assignment. It's really made me nervous and stressful. Well, that's all about my difficulties I encountered. Thank you.
So Susan, now that you're an expert on VoiceThread, you can teach all of our new classmates this semester, right? Okay, so there's some difficulties, there's some benefits, but what I would most like to know about are what kinds of suggestions the students would like to make to me or to new teachers who are interested in trying a flipped classroom. So who can tell us some of your suggestions?
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Vivian. Last semester, we've been learning using the flipped class, using the flipped approach, which is so interesting, so imaginable and inspiring. Despite the difficulties we encounter, it provides a practical methodology for not only GE courses in the University of Macau, but also courses in high schools and primary schools. And after experiencing and reflecting on the flipped class, we have some ideas and suggestions to share about the flipped class. And first, I think it's very important to keep balance of diversity and efficiency. It is true that this technology fully enrolls students' dynamic in class, but with so many technology being used, we find it a little excessive. Some of them have similar functions like Moodle Forum and Twitter and glossary entry, all of which could be used to post and leave comments. So I think if the process of using technology for homework could be more simplified without making it less interactive, that would be perfect. And this also applies to in-class efficiency. Sometimes we need to, in order to use applications and iPad, we need to spend some time handing out iPads, writing iPads, and handling with technology problems like looking for the applications, logging in, adapting to the operations of the iPad application, and so on. So I think if technology serves as a media, or I should say a forum for us to learn and communicate, so it's very important to keep the balance of the form and the content. And it's also a challenge for teachers because there should be different arrangements for different types of students in terms of nationalities, ages, and levels, and so on. And on the other hand, teachers, when applying flipped class, teachers need to adjust their focus of the work. They work more on designing the activities before or during and after class, and preparing materials and giving feedback rather than just giving lectures as in traditional class. Here I want to thank my teacher, Emily. She always spent a lot of time preparing various materials and handouts and records voice thread or screencast before class for us, and read and give feedback to students in order to keep our travel study. So this is really a lot of work, and I think the flipped class requires students to learn consciously and independently, so it's very important to keep track of students by communicating and giving feedback on time. In conclusion, I think in spite of those difficulties and drawbacks, I like it very much. And I think it would contribute greatly to educational innovation. And as a student, I hope that by reflecting and improving and gathering all your wisdom and care, more and more students will benefit from the flipped class.
To try to keep the conference on time, so I'm going to skip the last slides. On your handout, you do have where some of my data is published. Some of it is online, others not, but you can feel free to email me if you can't find it, and I can send you a PDF copy. The one thing that I do want to talk about with all of my findings is regarding especially these four girls. None of them are English majors. They're not even language majors, right? They're first-year students. They're 18 and 19 years old. Think about what you were doing when you were 18 and 19. Were you able to stand up in front of a group and make a presentation in a language that is not yours, right? So the fact that these girls are able to do it without a lot of sweat, it says a lot about the flip class, and I kind of think I'm doing something right. So again, if you're interested in the flipped classroom, definitely come tomorrow and get some hands-on experience. Thank you guys very much, and thank you.
Good job, you guys did an awesome job, thank you. Good job. We didn't have any time for questions, but maybe if someone